Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install and create React app, and after that I am also going to create a demo React project, and I am going to show you how to run that on our browser. So this video is going to be a bit informative, so I can recommend you to watch the video till the end. And if you watch the video till the end, I can promise you that you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now, to install React and to create a React project, you will need basically two things. One is Visual Studio Code and another is Node.js. So you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and you need to type over here Node.js download and hit enter, and you'll be able to see this Node.js as our link. So just simply open that. Immediately you'll be able to land over to the official site of Node.js. So this link I'm going to put right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over to the official site of Node.js. And here you can see we have two options. One is LTS one, another is a current one, right? So I'm going to recommend you to install LTS one. Alright, so LTS version at the time of making this video is version 20.11.0, and it also includes NPM. So NPM version is version 10.2.4. Alright, so depending upon what operating system you are using, Windows, macOS or any other, you need to select that operating system. I'm going to select Windows. And you can see it is properly started downloading our Node.js. Right, I have already downloaded it, so I'll minimize this. I'll go to my download directory, and you can see that our Node.js is rightly over here. So let's double click on our Node.js to install it locally on our system. So here you need to click on install anyway, and you can see welcome to Node.js setup wizard. So just simply click on next. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. Click on I accept, click on next. So this is our node destination folder, so you can keep this default. Click on next. So these are all files it's going to be installed. Also it's going to add our path to environment variable, so that's a very important step. So that is what it automatically going to do. So it is totally fine, just simply keep everything as a default. Click on next, and it is asking whether you'd like to install Chocolaty. I don't want to install Chocolaty for now, so I'll keep all the things as a default. Click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install, and there you go. It will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and our installation is rightly began. So by the time our Node.js get installed, I'll download our Visual Studio Code. So just simply open a new tab and just simply type Visual Studio Code, and let's click on this Visual Studio Code, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Visual Studio Code. So again, this link I'm going to put right in our description. So you need to click on this download for Windows, and you can see it immediately started downloading our Visual Studio Code over here. It just rightly started, right? So if you can go to our Node.js, you can see it is properly installed now. You can click on finish. So our Node.js is successfully installed, and our Visual Studio Code is, you know, downloaded over here. So just, you know, simply click on that link to install Visual Studio Code, and here click on install anyway. And this is our Visual Studio Code installation, you know, license agreement. You need to accept this, click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Totally fine. Click on next, and it's going to create Visual Studio Code start menu folder. Again, totally fine. Click on next, and it is also asking whether you like to create a desktop shortcut icon. Again, fine. Also check this open with code and click on next. So click on install, and it is preparing to install, and we're going to install it locally on our system. So let's minimize our browser and our download directory as well. So you can see our Visual Studio rightly started installing, and you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly installed. So also launch Visual Studio Code option is enabled. So just, you know, simply click on finish over here to launch our Visual Studio Code, and you can see our Visual Studio Code is rightly launched. So I'll close this. So now that you know that both our Node.js and our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed, so it's time to create our React app. So for that, let's first create a new, you know, folder over here. So let's create a new folder, and I'm going to give the folder name as React. And I'm going to go inside that folder, and I'm going to now just simply click on this address bar, and I'm going to just simply type cmd over here and hit enter. And immediately you'll be seeing that our, you know, command prompt is rightly open within our this directory, React directory on our desktop. So here, let's write one command to create our React app. So I'm going to just simply type npx and then create dash react dash app. And after that, I'm going to give the app name as my app, and I'm going to hit enter, and you can see it is telling that need to install the following package, the React app, right? So just simply type y, hit enter, and you can see it is fetching some of the files. So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation, so it can fetch all the files. So you can see creating new React app on this location, so installing all the packages and all. So this will take, you know, a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to get back to this video. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see success. Our React app is properly created over here. So happy hacking. So, you know, you can see our my app is rightly created within our React folder. So now let's go inside our React app folder. So cd, you know, my app, and hit enter. You are inside now our my app project that we have created. So now if you just simply type code then dot and hit enter, you can see it is, you know, rightly opened our Visual Studio Code. So where we have my app, right? So this my app is our React app. So you need to click on this I trust the authors, and you can see our my app is rightly opened over here. So you can expand our src folder to see all the files. So you can see we have our index.js file over here. Then we have our index.css file over here. We also have app.test file. So this is a testing file, and our app.js, app.cs, everything we have. So if you click on this package.json, you can see that our latest version of React at the time of making of this video, which is version 18.2.0, is rightly installed, right? And you can see our scripts as well. So start, build, test, eject, everything is properly written, right? So now what you need to do is you need to click on this triple dot and to enable these npm scripts. As soon as you enable that, you'll be seeing npm scripts over here. So just simply expand that and to click on start, run button of this start. So immediately you'll be able to see it is rightly started building our React project. So once it gets successfully builded, it's going to automatically redirect to our browser, so on our local host 3000 browser, and you can see that our React app is properly running, right, up and running. So you can minimize our browser first, and if you go to our app.js, we can see we have our div tag, then head tag, image tag and all. So whatever you are seeing, this, you know, React image, then this link is actually coming from here. So if you just simply, you know, remove this a tag, and if you also remove this p tag, and just simply give a h1 tag. So within h1 tag, if you just simply type hello world, and if you just simply save this file, it automatically going to compile and going to build our project. You can see it is successful. So if you go to your browser, immediately you can see it is changed with hello world, right? And our React logo is also, you know, up and running, and it is also revolving. So you can remove your logo, you can remove everything. So you can, if you remove everything like our image tag and all, control S. Now if you again go to browser, you can see nothing is there, right? And you can start, you know, writing your code over here. So in this way, you can easily create a React project on our Windows operating system. I have showed you how to install Visual Studio Code, then Node.js, how to set up our React project, everything on this video. I have also started Geeky Syntax channel, so if you're interested, you can always subscribe this channel. So here I'm going to post regularly coding related videos. So if you subscribe, that will really motivate me to make more such videos. And I have also started a Geeky Script blogging channel. So if you're interested, you can also subscribe this channel as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.